Hello and welcome to this video in our How My Computer Works series. My name is Matt Bauer and this week's video will focus on more tips for using Microsoft Outlook. The tips shown here are using Outlook 2007, so the steps may vary slightly if you're using an older version such as Outlook 2003. In case you missed my first two videos on Outlook, you can find them here and here. In those videos, I detailed several useful Outlook tips, and here are a few more. Create a distribution list. Do you find yourself sending emails to a certain group of people fairly often? Distribution lists will allow you to create a single contact that will act as a collection of contacts, so instead of typing each person's email address or adding them individually, you can add just one item from your contacts, which will contain all of the recipients. To do this, just click File, New, Distribution List. Type a name for it. Then click Select Members. Click the first contact you would like to add to the list. Then hold down the Control key on your keyboard while selecting the other contacts. When you have all of them selected, click the Members button on the bottom left. This will add them to the list. Then just click OK. Then Save and Close. Now, when you're addressing contacts in an email, you can type the name of the list you created instead of typing everyone's names individually. Create a simple rule. A rule is basically a way to tell Outlook to perform an action based on predetermined criteria. There are a lot of different ways to set up different types of rules, but here's one that's pretty common. Let's say you want to automatically direct all email from a specific sender to a certain folder. You can do this very quickly by first creating the destination folder. Right-click Inbox. Select New Folder. Give the folder a name, such as the specific sender's name, and click OK. Then find an email from that specific sender, right-click it, and select Create Rule. Check the top box indicating that you want the rule applied only to mail sent from this particular sender. Then check the Move the Item to Folder box. Make sure to select the folder you just created. Then click OK. Click OK once more, and you should be asked if you would like to run the new rule on all of the messages in the current folder. If you'd like to do this, check the box and click OK. If not, leave it unchecked and click OK. Now, when messages arrive from that sender, they will automatically be moved into the folder you created. Backup your Outlook files. It's a good idea to back up your Outlook data periodically in case disaster occurs. To do this, just click File, Import and Export, Export to a File, Next, Personal Folder File, PST. A PST file is the native file format that Outlook uses. Then, click Next. You can backup a specific folder by clicking it in the list, or you can scroll up to the topmost folder to backup all folders. In both cases, be sure to check this box to include all subfolders under the one you selected. Then, click Next. Click Browse and choose where to save the backup file. Then give it a name. If you make frequent backups, you may want to include the date in the file name.
Then click OK. Then finish. Then OK. Your backup may take a while depending on the amount of data you have in Outlook.
I'll cover more Outlook features and tips in a future video, but if you have any training ideas or suggestions, go ahead and send them to training@mycomputerworks.com. You can also subscribe to our My Computer Works YouTube video channel by clicking the subscribe button on the right side of any of our YouTube video pages. You can even find us on Facebook and Twitter by clicking the links in the More Info section of this video. If you have any questions about My Computer Works or would like more information about our services, you can go ahead and call the number you see below or just visit us online at mycomputerworks.com. My name is Matt Bauer. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.